Good day guys, Austin here, and in this one today, we're taking a close look at Dreamcast emulation. To be more specific, we're taking a look at one of the most cutting edge, hottest little creations out there at the moment, the Redream emulator. This one hasn't been around that long, but while it has been out, it has blown the doors off. Now, this one, I'm sure you've seen, it is very easy to get up and running. This one, as I'm sure you've seen, is quite a long video. The actual setup of it all takes seconds. You can actually do this by accident. But what I want to cover is quite a lot of the features that are involved with this emulator and the impact that it's making on the scene. It has become quite controversial. Now, that kind of stuff I'm going to leave till the end of the video, so stick around to see your views, your opinions. I'd love to hear them. But for now, let's get stuck in. So you are already late, the Dreamcast. Well, that's what we're doing today. And before we get stuck in, the great feature with this emulator is the fact that you do not need a BIOS to run it. It's been completely rewritten from scratch from the developer himself, Inlin, and he's done an awesome job, to be honest. It is 99% compatible with all games. However, that doesn't mean that all games are running. You can utilize an original BIOS file in there. And again, I'll show you how, and we'll talk about that more in just a second. But for now, I want to get us set up and running. But first, let's have a look at the compatibility list. 80% up and running, and to be honest, everything that I want to play is pretty good to go on here. The other one, and the biggie, is the fact that it doesn't run Windows CE games. Those are the games that had the little logo at the beginning when it came up, and basically it's just a requirement for, I would say, about 20 games on this system. To be honest, I would also say that it's not many games that I would like to play. In fact, off the top of my head, I think it's only Sega Rally 2 that really goes into that kind of thing, for me, personally anyway. But again, it depends on what games you like and which ones you want to run. But just like all the other games, or other emulators should I say, you've got that kind of problem there. The only emulator that runs Dreamcast and runs CE games is Demu. The issue with that emulator is that it's very system intensive. It requires a lot of system resources to run, which means that you need a pretty beefy rig to run all those games properly. Now, again, even if you did get it up and running, no one emulator for Dreamcast plays every game. So even if you did get it running, you'll still need another emulator to play the rest. So all I'm doing here is opening up the floodgates for you guys to at least have the chance to experience every game on this system. And again, for me, this one is the easiest one to start with. So finally, let's get this puppy set up. Jesus wept. So in the description down below, it will guide you to this section of the website here, which is the official download. Now, this is a paid emulator. Again, I'll talk about this more at the end of the video, but it's $5 and it does give you, the only difference is the resolution in terms of compatibility, performance. Everything else is exactly as the same as the free version. If you want to pump it all the way up to 4K, you have to pay $5 for that privilege. Am I agreeing with that? Again, at the end of the video, we'll talk about it there when I go more into the review side of this. So, all you need to do to get it up and running, and I would encourage you to at least try the free version out, guys. There's no tying in, there's no putting in details or anything like that, is to click on here. It will download it to your, wherever it is your download location is. While that's downloading, it's not big, create a new folder wherever it is you want to put it. The other great feature about this emulator is the fact that it's completely portable. So to put it in layman's terms, if I was to put this folder here, Redream, I can then move this entire emulator to a USB drive, take it onto another computer, load it up there, it works with all my original settings, all the games already on there if you do so wish. It's completely portable, so that's another valid option for this one. So let's open it up, the folder that we just created. Here's a download that we just downloaded from that link. It's a compressed file, so we need to extract it. All you need to do is drag it into the folder, and there we go, ready to roll. And that is the emulator in one file. Now, once we run this, it will make more files on our system. No need to worry. To get it to run, all you need to do is double click it. And the first thing that it asks, this is how easy it is, first thing that it asks, where's your games? So, click on Add Directory, And my games for this example are on my desktop here, Dreamcast games. So I just need to tell it where those games are. So whatever it is in your PC, find it. For me, it's desktop, Dreamcast games. And there's all the games within that folder there. But I want to choose the actual folder so it selects all the games. So click on this one, add that folder. And there we go. It's automatically put all the games into my emulator. It's also downloaded all the box art for it. And the great thing about this one is downloaded all the settings to get those games to run to the utmost. Now, there are some settings that you may need to mess around with. Depending on what kind of system you're running, go over to the system tab here. First one is your cable. Leave that as VGA. That's the best output you can get. That will be 480p. On the original Dreamcast console, that was the best there. The great thing with this emulator is some games did not support VGA, some games didn't support RGB, so on and so forth. And if you was to run it on another emulator and it was incompatible, you would have to load the game up, see if it ran or not, and then it would give you a warning screen, come back out, change the setting, all that kind of good stuff. This emulator automatically sets it to the highest possible setting possible, so you get the best experience. The rest of the stuff in here, again, don't worry about it. It's all just in there. It just automatically sets all the stuff. Other thing is this. Again, no need to mess around with. The only thing is polygon sort accuracy. This depends on what kind of system you are running. The lowest possible version is per mesh. Now, you will get a lot of graphical glitches on the screen running that kind of game, but you will need hardly any kind of PC to get that to run. This one, a little bit more intensive, but you will get less graphical errors. And again, click on the next one, per pixel. This is where things start getting more intense, but this is very low demanding in the grand scheme of things running emulators. So, to be honest, most systems will run this all the way up to 32 layers. You may see a bit more of a pull when you go into 64, but 64 is the most compatible with obviously almost zero artifacts on the screen. So if you can, push this all the way to 64. Obviously, if your system's struggling, then you may need to ramp that down to one of the previous settings. The rest of the stuff, don't mess with. Input wise, your controller is completely set up and ready to rumble straight out the box. It automatically picks it up and it automatically binds all your keys as it would be with the normal layout of a controller. I threw everything into this and it ran straight out the box. So again, if you want to mess around with any settings here, feel free, but I would keep it as it is for now. Library wise, we've already done that to add our games, and then the next thing is just games. So right now we're playing this on the best settings possible on the free version, and well, let's give it a try. So all you need to do is click on it and it will just load. No BIOS messing around, no messing around with settings or anything like that. We literally downloaded it, installed it on the PC, told it where the games were and clicked on the game. That is about it. That's as complicated as this one gets. And then if you want to full screen it, you can double click it or you can do that in the settings also. So now, if I was to get in game, as you can see, we're up and running and everything is tickety-boo. So that is basically how you get this to run. Now again, we're using the free version now. So this will be running at 480p internal resolution on here. But as you can see, Dreamcast games actually look pretty damn good at 480p. Some of you, if you want to save your pennies, may not need to upgrade. So again, it's your own wish. So the other thing that you need to consider is BIOS files. Now, if you are having compatibility issues and you want it to run to its utmost, you can, of course, like I said, use the official BIOS from the Dreamcast. All you need to do is get it, back it up from your system, or download it from the Tinterwebs and rename it to boot.bin. Drag it into your actual folder. And that will now give you boot from BIOS. So now if I was to click on that, it boots from the actual BIOS as if I just put something into the system. And now I've also got access to my VMU, in other words, my same games within the BIOS. You don't need that kind of stuff. Again, I'm just showing you different examples, but that's one of the features that brings to the table. Now, if I was to load a game, for example, Shenmue again. It now gives me the boot screen or the BIOS screen as it boots up because I'm booting it from the BIOS. It automatically detects and it will boot from that BIOS. So that's another thing that we've covered. Next one then is the obvious elephant in the room, which is the paid version. So on the website, there is the download license for me. Obviously, because I have paid for this, I'm a contributor, I've got access for this. Once you've paid that $5, it will give you the little download license bit. You can download it to your computer to get this up and running with the extra features, in other words, added resolution. All you need to do is then drag this. In fact, let's go onto there first, and then you should be able to see it show up. All you need to do is drag this over. Load up Redream video, and now we've got internal resolution, and you can set this to whatever you want. So again, let's pump this up. Let's go all the way to Jesus. Where that goes to some high resolution. I don't know why you'd want to go that far, but hey, let's go up to about 4K. Run Shenmue again. Let's fast forward. So now, as you can see, we've got Shenmue running. It's in fully fledged 4K resolution to its utmost. So it's up to you. Is it worth the $5? For me, yeah, because I think this developer's come on and brought a lot to the table. Re-engineering a BIOS, bringing such user-friendly experience to running these kind of games, and bringing this kind of performance from what I would say quite low-end systems, I think it's worth them $5. But again, it's up to you guys at the end of the day. So here's a comparison between the two. Of course, no need for 4K. You could probably go up to 1080p on this and you'd still be just as happy. But it's nice to have that kind of option available to us. So that is basically us up and running. The only thing that I would say again is obviously Sega Rally won't work, because even though we've got the official BIOS, it won't load into the game because it demands Windows CE. Come on, Windows CE. And it will just basically halt at that screen because the emulator can't produce it at this moment in time. So exit out of there. Obviously, you can get Jet Set Radio going. The only other thing that I would say is that some games are available as hacks on this system. For example, I've got Shenmue in widescreen and with the Coca-Cola modification. In some countries, Shenmue ran, and basically, because of licensing issues, they couldn't include the Coca-Cola text on the vending machines. It sounds like a little thing, but it's nice that we have these options available now to have these added in. So this version will run in widescreen and it will run with the Coca-Cola vending machines. Now the emulator itself doesn't have the option of widescreen. It's not the way the games work, but you can hack the actual games to have widescreen on there. So because we are running a widescreen one, I want to set this to either stretch basically. That will then give us the widescreen option. So there we go, that is Shenmue Rao in 4K, widescreen, all the hacks at its utmost fidelity. It's about as good as you can get for all this. And for me, it's the definitive way until a couple of weeks time when the new version comes out on the PC. But obviously, Dreamcast catalog is absolutely huge. You can play all games, obviously compatible ones, to this kind of fidelity, looking absolutely beautiful on your system. And I again would say that this is the way Dreamcast should be played, especially for people who are new to emulators or anything like this. This emulator is great. So now I want to address the biggest elephant that has ever existed in the entire world and get some facts straight, allow you guys to make an informed decision, give my point of view, and well, get some facts straight for the entire community so you guys can make up your own mind. Redream is one of the hottest Dreamcast emulators out there at the moment, with its lead developer Inalin. Its focus is on centralizing stability and usability, with the latter being the best feature in my opinion. This is by far the easiest emulator to get up and running I have ever used. A great interface, a backend that automatically sets compatibility settings to allow you just to boot games and enjoy them. Even the controls and the video settings are automatically populated on game launch. Meaning, to get a game working, all you need to do is just download, show it where the games are, and click, and that's it, you are gaming. Although free to download and use in its light build, there is also a premium version. In terms of compatibility, performance and accuracy, there is no difference. The premium version offers higher resolutions up to 4K, coming in at the princely sum of $5. As of yet, it is the only emulator that does not need an original Dreamcast BIOS, as Inland himself has rewrote one from scratch. At the moment, it is very close to the compatibility of the original console BIOS, although, for best results, some games will get better accuracy through the original Dreamcast BIOS, but this is improving all the time. With development for this starting in 2014, it's amazing how far this has come. The original code was released in open source, but with lack of interest due to likely already popular emulators, it had little to no support progressing and the emulator was starting to stagnate. With companies and projects using the code to port games and load emulators onto paid devices, giving nothing back in terms of recognition, code or users, Inland decided to close the source and fork his own build. This is the build that we see today, with the extra cash revenue coming in from premium versions, able to invest more time into the emulator, meaning along with his custom BIOS, is now become one of the most user-friendly, compatible and stunning emulators you can use to emulate the Dreamcast console. Inland stating, "I have no plans to take the source code to my grave, it was just a decision that let me keep making progress at the time. I do not see this as a permanent decision." With him being so close to many of the other Dreamcast emulators and them working so close together, although some of these emulators may be closed source, it seems to be more of a way of protecting the original code from abuse from third parties, cashing in on their hard work and giving nothing back in return, even when protected by license. In this case, providing one of the most user-friendly and well-developed emulators available, which only happened recently with the added development from its funding and focus. To summarize it all up then, I would say that this, if you just want to get your games working, it's the perfect choice. That is as easy as I can get it. There are more compatible emulators out there and we will be covering them in future videos. I even want to bring to you an entire history of Dreamcast emulation. It is a bit of rumors going around with this being closed source, with the fact that money's involved in all this. For me, the Dreamcast emulator, Redream, is completely free. The only thing you pay for is added features. And that money, it goes towards development. Development that wasn't happening without it. So if you like it, you buy it. And if you don't, you don't. That's as easy as I can get it, to be honest. For me, I think this guy has done God's work in terms of emulation. He has brought it out of the doldrums and he's brought a spurt of energy into Dreamcast emulation, and it's flooding into other emulators on the same system also. And like I said, we'll be covering them in the future. But for now, hopefully this has shed some light. Hopefully this has not only got your game up and running, but you kind of understand where it's coming from, where it's been, and what it's doing in the future. So, as always guys, thank you very much for joining me today. It's been an absolute pleasure bringing this to you. This was all possible thanks to my Patreon supporters, and I thank each and every one of you. Without your support, we wouldn't be getting here now. But please like, please subscribe, please do all the things that you could ever imagine in this wonderful world where we get to play Shenmue before it's actually released on PC. How crazy is that? But most of all, you have a good day. Laters!